Dan Gowdy, Assistant Professor in Mathematics, Center for Distance Education, Shivaji University, Kolhapur. Today I discuss Lagrange's formulations from the classical mechanics and MSc Force and Semester Force subject classical mechanics first unit is Lagrange's formulations. Before that, Lagrange's formulations, we study the basic concept related to mechanics, definition of mechanics, velocity of the particle, distance covered by the particle, angular momentum of the particle, linear momentum of the particle, so many of the things. First one, definition of mechanics. What is the definition of the mechanics? Mechanics is the branch of the applied mathematics which deals with the study of the motion of the particle or system of the particle with the forces. One example related to the mechanics, related to the motion of the particle, related to the system of the particle with the forces. Suppose a bullet is fired from a fixed point in XY coordinate system is origin. Suppose a bullet is fired from a fixed point with initial velocity u, not exactly vertically upward but making an angle alpha with the horizontal, then what is instrument mathematician used for the measurement of the speed of the bullet, motion of the bullet, or system of the bullet at that instant? What is the acceleration? What is the velocity of the particle of the bullet at the end of its journey? such a difficulties, mathematician need not any meter clock, any clock to measure the distance, measure the time, need not sufficient. Mathematician simply use Cartesian coordinate or coordinate. These are independent coordinate. What is coordinate? What type of coordinate use? The mathematician use only three coordinates for simple. The hands of a mathematician are the coordinates. With the help of these coordinates are the motions of to measure the motion of the particle or system of the particle completely as described. To discuss the motion of the bullet, take a point P of xy in coordinate xy coordinate system, any point on the path of the bullet. The only force acting on the bullet is the gravitational force in the downward direction. Resolving the force horizontally and vertically, we write from the Newton's second law of motions the equation of motion as x double dot is equal to 0 and y double dot is equal to minus g. What is x double dot and y double dot? Acceleration of the bullet at the with respect to x coordinate, with respect to y coordinate. Integrating x double dot and y double dot simultaneously, we get x dot is equal to u cos alpha and y dot is equal to u sin alpha minus gt, where u is the initial velocity of the particle bullet when t is equal to 0. And this way, integrating against with using initial condition, we obtain x is equal to u cos alpha t, y is equal to u sin alpha t minus 1 upon 2 gt square. This equation determine the velocity of the particle bullet at an instant time t, and x is equal to u sin u cos alpha t and y is equal to u sin alpha t minus 1 upon t gt square. Determines the motion of the bullet at that instant, and further we eliminate t from the equation x and y, we get y is equal to x tan alpha minus 1 upon t gx square divided by u square cos square alpha. This equation gives the path of the bullet, and path is a parabola. The motion of the particle like a parabola. Motion bullet travels in a parabola shape. The coordinates used to describe the motion of the particle and system of the particle must be linearly independent. If not, then the number of the equations describe the motion of the particle or motion of the system will be less than the number of variable, and in this case the solution cannot be uniquely determined. For example, if the particle moves freely in space, then three coordinates, three linearly independent coordinates are used to describe the motions. These are either the Cartesian coordinate x, y, z or spherical coordinate r, theta, phi. If, however, the particle is moving along one of the coordinate axes in space, then all the three coordinates are not independent. Hence, their three coordinates cannot be used for its description along a coordinate axis. Only one coordinate varies and other two coordinates are constant, and only the varying coefficient or varying coordinate can be used to describe the motion of the particle. This is mathematician use three independent coordinates to describe the motion of the particle or system of the particle. Now one more example, one more basic concept, velocity. What is velocity? Velocity is nothing but change of displacement with respect to time t. V is equal to r bar dot. So v is the velocity of the particle and r is the displacement of the particle traveled by travel in time t. If r bar is equal to xi plus yj plus zk, the position vector, and the velocity of the particle is v is equal to